Current electricity, chapter 3 of physics. We'll continue today with cells, EMF, internal resistance. First we'll define cell. So definition is a device to maintain a steady current in an electric circuit is the electrolytic cell. Okay, so that is the definition of a cell. And little construction is given, introduction about this cell. A cell has two electrodes. Okay, you can see this is electrode 1, this is electrode 2. Okay, electrode means positive and negative. This place are positive and negative, they are called electrodes. Positive and P and negative N. Okay, so positive, this P is written, so this is positive, and this N is written, so this is negatively, negative electrode. Okay? They are immersed in an electrolytic solution. So they are immersed here. This is electrolytic solution. Okay, this is a solution which is electrolytic. Dipped in the solution, the electrodes exchanges charges with electrolyte. The positive electrodes has potential difference V plus greater than 0, and negative electrodes has potential difference minus V minus, and the total will be equal to EMF. Okay, so see, this is positive and this is negative. So the this positive has got potential plus V, and this has got potential V minus. Both are positive, but the potential will be for minus V. So this is maximum potential here, maximum potential here. Okay, and they are immersed in this solution. Okay, and this total sum will be EMF. Okay, equal to EMF. So now we'll define the EMF. EMF is electromotive force. Okay, that is the expansion, or this is the meaning of electromotive force is EMF. It is written. It's not a force. It is actually the volt only, but it is used as, it is written as force, but it is not the force, and it is symbol is used like this E, and the definition will be electromotive force E is the potential difference between terminals of the cell when no current is drawn from the cell. So when no current is drawn, then the circuit is not connected. This is not connected, suppose. Okay, it is disconnected. That means whatever here potential is at this positive, it is V plus. And for this it is V minus, or minus of V minus. That means the highest potential when this is not circuit is not connected. Okay, you can say that it is like here one key is put. Okay, a key is put here and it is not connected. When it is not connected, then whatever is the potential difference between these two, we call it as a EMF, the highest potential difference. Okay, that is called EMF. So here see, I have written here V plus V minus. V plus I am taking as a potential difference for the positive electrode, and V minus for the negative. So the total will be EMF. Okay, and this is in the words that EMF is the potential difference between terminals of the cells when no current is drawn from the cell. No current means circuit is open. Then internal resistance. Internal resistance is connected with the cell. It is the resistance offered by the electrolyte means this solution. Okay, the solution here. Okay, so in this solution we have some resistance plus these electrodes. These are the electrodes. Okay, so there is a resistance between these electrodes and this electrolyte solution. Okay, between the solution, electrolyte solution, and between the electrodes, the resistance is there. That is called your internal resistance. So this is the cell. Okay, in this cell it happens. So once again let us read. It is the resistance offered by the electrolyte and electrodes of a cell when the current flows through it, and it happens when current is flowing through it. Okay, so that is the definition of internal resistance, and symbol is used as small r. Terminal potential difference. Okay, so what do you mean by terminal potential difference? Terminal means between the two points. It is the potential difference between two electrodes of a cell in a closed circuit when current is drawn from it. So now when you current are drawing from it, there is a potential difference that we call it as a terminal potential. So V is equal to V plus V minus. This is EMF, okay? Total minus IR. So the formula is V is equal to E minus IR. Okay? So that's the formula for terminal potential difference. Okay? Sometimes we consider this E and V almost the same. Okay, if the resistance is very small, then we consider that E and V are almost the same. By Ohm's law, we know V is equal to I into R. Okay, so put instead of V, IR. So instead of V, IR, E minus IR. Okay, transfer this IR here. So IR plus IR is equal to E remains here. This is electromotive force. Take I common, so he remains capital R plus R. This capital R is the resistance connected in the circuit. Okay, then this should have transfer here, it will come in the denominator. Okay, in this circuit you can see this is a cell. It has got EMF E, internal resistance R, and this capital R is the resistance of a circuit. This is external. Okay, you can connect here a bulb or any other object which you want to use this current. Okay, with the power you want to use there, you can connect here. So that is the one. So this is my current. The current from here will be E plus E by R plus R. Now what will be the maximum current? Maximum current is when, see, this R is fixed. It is inside the cell, so you can't change. Only you can change this R. So this R can be 0. If I put R equal to 0, then I is maximum. So the maximum current is given by E by R. Okay, so that is the formula. Then we have got next cells in series and parallel. So first we'll see in a series. Okay, series means one of the positively connected to another and the other one is left or connected with another one. Okay, another cell or other another cell or the battery. Consider two cells with EMFs E1, E2 and internal resistance R1, R2. Okay, this E1, E2, R1, R2 are the resistance. Connected in series, where one terminal of the cell is joined together. Okay, this one is joined together and other one is left free. Together, leaving the other free. Okay, the other side is free or connected to other part of the circuit. Let VA, I am taking two points A, B, C. Okay, so we are taking the potential at A as VA, potential B as VB and C as VC. Be the potential difference at points A, B and C. Potential difference between AB. So VAB is given as VA minus VB. So from the last we can write at this for the first battery. Okay, first battery, the potential will be, terminal potential will be E1 minus IR1. Okay, and for this will be E2 minus IR2 because I is the current from the battery, circuit. Okay, so we can write VAB is equal to E1 minus IR1. And for BBC, the potential between BC will be VBC, VB minus VB, and it can be written as E2 minus IR2 from the previous understanding. Potential difference between AC. Now, not from direct from A to C, what will be the potential between A and C? Okay, so it will be potential difference between AB plus potential difference between BC. Okay, so I have written here. VAC is equal to VAB plus VBC. And VAB, you put the value this E1. E1 minus IR1, okay, E1 minus IR1, and VBC from here E2 minus IR2. Okay, now E1 and E2 I am taking together, minus IR1 minus IR2. From this you take I common, so here remains R1 plus R2. Okay, call it number 1. Now suppose if the combination is replaced, combination means instead of two cells we separate, we replace it by one single cell. Replaced by a single cell between A and C of EMF E equivalent and internal resistance R equivalent. Then what we can write as VAC will be E equivalent minus R equivalent number 2. Okay, see this part here. Now these two separated, these two combination are replaced by this one whose battery's EMF is equivalent to these two and resistance is equivalent, and this is between A and C. So replace these two by one equivalent battery. Okay, then now we can compare this 1 and 2. So when you compare E equivalent, that will be E1 plus E2. Okay? And R is same. So R equivalent will be R1 plus R2. So what we can conclude from here, that there is a rule, series rule. We can conclude that the equivalent EMF of a series combination of N cells is just the sum of the individual EMF. So E1, E2, E3 up to EN. Okay? And the equivalent internal resistance of series combination for N cells just the sum of their internal resistance. So R1, R2, R3 up to Rn. Okay? And suppose here we have connected positive and negative. Suppose two negatives are connected together. Okay, then what happens? VBC will become minus of E2. Okay, minus IR2, and equivalent will be E1 minus I2. So there will be little change if I connect two negative together. Okay, here we have connected one negative, one positive. So it comes positive, but here it will become different. Now this one is a parallel combination. Okay, so this one is called parallel. You can see these two are connected together, these two are connected together. So when you connect like this, the potential difference between B1 and B2 will be same. So potential difference for this battery and this battery will be equal. Okay, consider parallel combination of cells E1, E2 with internal resistance R1, R2. Same like previous. Currents I1 and R2 leaves positive electrodes of cell at B1, I1 and I2 flows in and I flows out. Now here what happens at this point B1 and B2, the current is coming like this. Okay, so at this point this is called junction. So it is passing half, some of them will go this side and some current will go here. Okay, so the sum which is going here you call I1, which is going here I2, but total will be I. Then they will pass from here, again here it will be I1, I2, and at B1 it will come out as total I. Okay, so I is divided into I1, I2, but here potential difference will be same, okay, at the point B1 and B2, but current is different passing from E1 and E2, but potential is the same, okay. So now let's write potential. Let VB1 and VB2 be potential at B1 and B2. So potential difference for cell E1 will be same formula like the what we learned today, V is equal to E1 minus IR1. But this can be written as VB1 minus VB2, and this answer is E1 minus IR1. Okay, we'll just simplify this part. So IR1 and EV we are interchanging, okay, and interchanging here. So VI transfer here becomes negative, and this minus I1 you transfer positive. I want to find I1 actually. So you transfer R1, it will go in the denominator. So I1 is equal to E1 minus V divided by R1, call it number 2. Potential difference for cell E2 between B1 and B2. So potential difference again same V. Okay, I have written the same. V B1 minus V B2. So V is equal to E2 minus IR2. Okay, same like the previously, the internal resistor, the terminal potential. Okay, again I interchange V here and IR2 here, I2R2 here. So I2R2 is equal to E2 minus V, transfer R2 here, it will go in the denominator. So R2. So now we combine equation 2, 3 and 1. The one was this one, I is equal to I1 plus I2. So put the value of I1 from 2, I1 from here and I2 from here. Okay, so I am placing these two values here. So I have placed here E1 minus V divided by R1 plus E2 minus V divided by R2. Then I am just dividing each term. So E1 by R1 minus V by R1. Plus E2 by R2 minus V by R2. Okay. Again, I am going to rearrange. So this E1, E2 term together I am taking, and this I am taking together, plus minus V taking common. So here remains 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. Okay. Here I can take LCM. Okay. Here LCM is taken in this first part. So when I am taking LCM, it becomes E1 R2. Okay. Plus E2 R1. Okay. Divided by the LCM is R1 R2. Also here it is I, so I am interchanging this V minus V, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 I am transferring here, and this plus I am transferring here becomes minus. Okay. Here also I can take LCM. If I take LCM, what comes here? R2, just like cross multiplication. Okay, R2 plus R1, so I can write R1 plus R2. Okay. So here comes V is equal to V into R1 R2 R1 plus R2 divided by R1 R2. Okay, this part. And this side is same as this. E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2. Okay, minus I. Okay, now what you have to do? You have to transfer this side. So when you transfer towards the other side, what happens is, see, if I transfer this the other side, so this side it becomes V is equal to, I have got E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 R2. Okay, when I transfer there, it comes R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, so this R1 R2 cut. So I get first part E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divided by R1 plus R2. Okay, this part. Okay, this part will get. And I am also transferring this, na? So it will multiply here R1 with I. So R1 R2 R1 plus R2. Okay, it is multiplying. It will not cancel, but for the first one, the denominator cancels. Okay, therefore here E1 R2 plus E2 R1. I have by R1 R2, this R1 R2 will cancel. R1 plus R2 remains. Okay, so now this is called equation A. If now like the previously, if we replace this combination by a single cell between B1 and B2 of EMF E equivalent and internal resistance R equivalent, then V is equal to E equivalent minus I R equivalent, call it number B. Now we compare these two. So when you compare, you can say E equivalent is this part and R equivalent is this part. Okay. So this one, in other words, we can say that this is, if I divide this, if I take the ratio of these two, E R equivalent divided by R equivalent. Okay, suppose you take the ratio of these two. So what we will get? R1 plus R2 will cancel. So we will get only this E1 by E2 plus E2 by E2 by R2. Okay, so this part you get. You divide and see. If you want to try, you can just see E equivalent divide by R equivalent. Okay, so I'll divide this. So E equivalent is E1 R2 plus E2 R1 divide by R1 plus R2. And this you have to take a reciprocal. So reciprocal will be into, this will go in the numerator R1 R2 divide by R1 R2. Okay, so this R1 plus R2 you cut and this you divide E1 R2 plus E2 R1, okay, divide by R1 R2. Each term you divide, so E1 R1, E2 R2 will cancel, R2 R2 cancel, here remains E1 by R1. Here when you divide this by R1 cuts, remains E2 by R2. So we can just write it directly E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2. Now if it is in for n cells, then you can just write that 1 by R equivalent equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus up to plus 1 by Rn. And this you can write R equivalent divided by E equivalent divided by R equivalent for n capacity, for n it will be E1 by R1 plus E2 by R2 plus up to plus En by Rn. And just like previously, if negative of second is connected to positive of first, then E2 will be written as minus E2. The above equation will be valid, true, but E2 will convert into negative. Thank you very much.